Hello everybody and welcome to a new series I'm going to be playing called Tales of Monkey Island. I'm Subliminal Versus, let's get started. I'm really looking forward to this series. This is nostalgic for me, this kind of game. I played all the old ones. If you don't know what they are, please go and play them. They are absolutely amazing games. It's just me all over. Love this kind of style. It's suitable for loads of people. It's a bit like The Simpsons, you know. You can watch it as a child, you can watch it as an adult. So, you know, there is that adult humour in it. But no, it's great. I'm not going to talk too much through this because there's a lot of dialogue. So anyway, let's get started.
At last, my victory is at hand. Har, har, har. Behold, the legendary 13th monkey of Montevideo. Har, whose sacrifice will eternally bind the oceans themselves to my infernal will. Har, har. Yet.
Not half as much as I'll be when Guybrush guts your diseased carcass with his voodoo cutlass, you doddering sack of scum.
I wouldn't hold your breath waiting for any last-minute heroics, me dear. The last I saw of your mighty pirate husband, he was being torn apart by a school of my ravenous piranha poodles.
All right, LeChuck, put down the monkey and back away from my wife.
Guybrush!
Arr, Threepwood! You've led me a merry chase, but soon the dread mysteries of these ancient simians will be mine, and the seas will run red with the blood of my enemies. Arr, arr, arr!
Yeah, well, you fight like a...
No time to waste, Guybrush. Finish enchanting that sword before LeChuck completes his spell.
I'm on it. One LeChuck defeating cursed cutlass of Kafloo coming up. Now, where did I leave those handy voodoo instructions?
They're pinned to your mast.
Oh, yeah.
Okay, so enter Guybrush. What have we got here? So, just getting used to the controls here.
Come to Guybrush, you spooky voodoo recipe, you. Well, I had to sail 6 of the 7 major seas to find the ingredients, but I finally finished the cutlass. Almost. Now all I need to do is find some fizzy root beer to spray on it, and LeChuck's as good as toast. Icky disease toast.
Right, so, we've got to find ourselves some voodoo root beer. This is what I mean, such a random game, but love it.
Ah, the legendary monkey casket of Kauai. I'll never forget the horrible hula of Hades I had to do to get this thing. Is this thing sloshy? More words you don't want to hear when you pick up a coffin.
That's the last thing you want to hear when you're picking up a coffin, but there we go. Right, so. Let's examine the coffin.
I wonder how you open this thing. Aha! A seltzer bottle full of root beer. I haven't seen one of these since before I had a beard. Bet this stuff will work wonders on my cutlass.
Okay, so.
Time to give this cutlass a root beer shower. Flat root beer? What kind of second-rate voodoo seltzer bottle has flat root beer?
Right, so I've got a feeling. You know what I say, Mentos and Coke. Let's combine these bad boys. Ah, see?
Whoa, this city.
There we go, so. Voodoo root beer and a nice sword, so.
Prepare to meet your frosty carbonated maker, LeChuck.
Arr! Come and get me a dirt-digging doily dipper! Arr!
Stop showboating and spray the sword, Guybrush!
I'm showboating, I'm...
Oops. And now we're going to die. Again. Wonderful.
Okay, no problem. I just need to find a fresh supply of impossible-to-find voodoo root beer. I sure hope there's some on Elaine's ship, because mine's as dry as a bone. And not one of those wet bones. I'm talking a dry, dry bone.
Right, so let's...
Elaine, my beautiful butter!
What?
I said, Elaine, my beautiful butter!
My beautiful butter?
I was gonna say buttercup, but you keep cutting me off.
Oh, Guybrush. Now stop the chuckle, we're all dead.
Elaine, you've got inordinately strong thighs. See if you can swing me that rope.
It's not long enough. A better idea.
Well, that worked. Go, Guybrush, come on.
How'd you do that?
It had spent several years at the side of Guybrush Threepwood, mighty pirate, without picking up a few tricks, darling.
My ship, my booty, my collection of autographed sextants.
We'll buy you some more sextants later. Just stop LeChuck.
Ah, Threepwood. So good of you to join us. Saves me the trouble of having to sink your ship.
Oh dear, he's lost his booty.
Nothing can stop me now.
Those roots could really use a trim.
Sorry.
Yes.
Let's see if we can cut back some of those unruly roots. There, much neater.
So I can see where we're going with this. Obviously root, and then you've got some grog or beer. So, you'd think that...
Let's see if these roots add anything to this horrible not-grog. Ugh. This root grog is bland, joyless, and jejune. It's also flat.
Yes!
So, more mints.
Yes!
Here we go.
Now that's some fizzy root grog. I bet it still tastes like monkey stomp, though.
Right, and finally, the cutlass.
Okay, you barrel of disgusting low-cal goo. Make yourself useful. Booyah! Look out, LeChuck! Here comes Guybrush Threepwood's glowing sword of hot monkey vengeance!
A bit worried about that amount of liquid and gunpowder over there, but... There we go. Let's take on LeChuck.
LeChuck! Do you mind? I'd be in the middle of an unholy ceremony here.
Unholy this!
Unholy this?
Yeah, I know, but he didn't give me much to work with. Hey!
Arr, you can't defeat me that easily, Sheepwood. Wait, what's happening?
Is that how the cutlass is supposed to work?
I don't know, it's so bright. What the heck?
Woof.
I'm human.
That's debatable.
Guybrush, quick! Finish him off!
What? Oh, right! This is for the monkeys, LeChuck!
What are you doing? Finish him!
It's not me, it's my hand! It won't... Uh-oh.
That's like me cutting shapes on the dance floor, eh?
Elaine!
Guybrush?
Oh, it's tanking shit at least. So yeah guys, I really hope you're going to enjoy this series as much as I love this game. I think Telltale so far have done a great job of this. You know, I'm one of those people, I'm a very big fan of Telltale. I just think they really take on the project. And, you know, just work wonders with this. The only thing is, I think they've changed the voice of LeChuck, but there we go. Can't have everything. So yeah, I'm going to be working on this for a little while, but we will come back to the Fallout series at some point. I just don't want to work too much on one series. I want to change things up a little bit. So yeah, here we go.
Hearty.
What?
Don't worry, we'll have you up and sucking back a grog in.
No, my dude! My beautiful pirate dude! I'll get you for this, you craven bilge rat!
Sorry, I don't know what got.
Oh dear.
To me. Oh, this can't be good.
You know, you really should have that look, that kid.
Huh?
The name's Nipperkin. Davy Nipperkin, senior reporter, Keel Harbor Gazette. Welcome to Flotsam Island. Mind if I ask you a few questions?
Actually,
great. What's your name, where'd you come from, and how'd you get here?
I'm Guybrush Threepwood, Mighty Pirate. There we go.
I'm Guybrush Threepwood, Mighty Pirate, and...
Pirate, eh? Well, I believe it when I see it, kid. Still, it'd be nice to have a real genuine pirate buckling his swash around Flotsam Island again. Why, I haven't had an honest-to-goodness pirate story to write about in over 6 months. Yes, sir, Bob. Nothing like the promise of a good pirate story to get the old journalistic juices flowing again, says
hey.
I. Say, just listen to me prattling on while you stand there all wet and confused and whatnot. So, what's your story, Creepwood?
This island looks, lovely, but where can I find a ship? I really need to get back to the Rock of Gelato and find my wife.
Well, there's only one ship here on Flotsam Island, but it won't do you any good.
Why not?
It's the winds, Threepwood. The winds! Here on Flotsam Island, the winds are always blowing inward 24 hours a day, 365 days a year. It's a freak of nature, a fluke, a curse. Whatever you want to call it, the result is the same. Once you've landed on Flotsam Island, you're trapped!
Are you seriously telling me there's no way off this island?
Well, not by ship, anyway. The only person who I think might know a way off the island is Deep Gut.
Deep Gut? Is Elaine's mother here? Yeah, we'll go with that.
Deep Gut?
No.
What's a Deep Gut?
Deep Gut's my secret source for off-island news stories, and it's a good thing, too. Without the Gut's uncanny inter-island scoops, the Keel Harbor Gazette would never be able to compete with those snooty prima donnas over at the Flotsam Times.
Off-island news? Hey, then he might know something about Elaine. Where can I find this Deep Gut?
Hold on a second, pirate boy. Davy J. Nipperkin doesn't go handing over his secret sources to every Tom, Dick, and Guybrush that washes ashore.
But I can pay you with treasure from my ship. Which is probably at the bottom of the ocean by now.
Look, kid, you seem like a nice enough pirate, so I'll make you a deal.
A deal? I won't have to dress up like a sheep, will I? A deal, okay, but no blood signatures. Right, let's go with the first one.
A deal?
Yeah, off-island news is nice and all. But the fair citizens of Flotsam are getting tired of stories about faraway lands they'll never see again. Not to mention that I hate being beholden to this Deep Gut person.
So?
So I need some nice, meaty, local pirate news.
I love making pirate news.
That's the spirit, kid! You can translate that moxie into news-making pirate mayhem, and I'll hand you Deep Gut on a silver platter!
Yeah, this'll be a snap. A snap. A snap. Ow!
So here we go, guys. Chapter 1, Launch of a Screaming Narwhal. The only thing I have noticed is I don't really use the script that's in front of you, but I think that's just for your own amusement rather than anything else. But other than that, I mean, look, it's just a really pretty game, I think. Don't know what happened there, but there we go. Right. So,
card?
Card? What card?
Okay, so I need a card.
printer's ink, the lifeblood of the newspaper industry, lovingly harvested from squid udders.
What are squid udders? I'm gonna start using that word now.
I guess court isn't in session today, which is probably a good thing considering all the laws I'll be breaking. Pirates plundering your palace? Buccaneers bashing your balustrades? Swashbucklers slicing your stomachs? Then you need Morgan Le Fay, pirate hunter par excellence. Great, a pirate hunter. I need that like I need a fourth nipple.
Okay, so he's got three nipples already. Dear, oh dear. Four nipples. I'm just going to have an explore around a little bit. See what's going on. So yeah, you guys are going to need to let me know.
Flowers. What a crummy sconce. I'd better pick this up before someone notices, trips over it.
You're going to need to let me know what you think of Monkey Island series, if you've played it before, or, you know, if you haven't and you like the look of this. Because I loved this game as a kid, and to be honest, I'm loving it now still. So I'm so pleased they made this. I know this isn't the newest game ever, but...
Holy screaming starfish! I think I've just found my ride off this stinking island.
Not so fast, my well-coiffed friend.
Who?
Reginald Van Winslow, captain of the Screaming Narwhal. And you are?
Guybrush Threepwood, mighty pirate.
Oh, really? What can I do for you, Mr. Mighty Pirate?
Do you know anything about Club 41?
Club 41? Wonderful place. I haven't been there since I lost my membership card when I seized the narwhal.
Nice, so we've got to find the card that he's lost. Prepare to be boarded.
Heave to and strike your colors. I've come to seize your ship.
You have? Jolly good. No one's been man enough to take the Screaming Narwhal for over 2 years.
Huh. He's got a really good attitude for someone who's about to lose his ship.
Alright, so let's take this ship then.
Be seeing ya.
I look forward to it.
Oh. Oh, look, see. Hold on a sec. I know which way this is gonna go.
Prepare to be boarded then, Winslow.
Bacon grease, boyo. Slickest stuff in the seven seas.
Oh, crud. This jacket was an anniversary present. And now it's all covered with bacon grease. Man, is Elaine gonna be PO'd.
Bacon. I love me some bacon. Fine. Okay. I will board this ship.
Oh, dang.
Hot. Oh dear.
And now the dock is smoldering. Perfect.
Okay, so we're not going up either of those ways.
Hey, there's something in this sock. Club 41. Probationary member number 37, Reginald Van Winslow.
I was actually trying to click on the rope there, so that's, can you click on the rope? Ah. Clothesline.
Alley-oop! Uh-oh. Hey!
I'll take that as a no, then. Right, okay, so we're gonna have to find some kind of way just to get up there. I'll come back to that later. So yeah, as I was saying, you guys, yeah, just let me know what you think of this series, because
trimmer tail!
Yeah, just let me know. See, tell me if you want me to carry on with it. I'm going to play it for a bit anyway, because, like I said, I love this game, so... Or love this series, should I say. Let's go talk to this guy. Crimp Digit.
Ahoy there, scruffy artisan. I'm Guybrush Threepwood, mighty pirate.
Ahoy yourself. I be Gaffer Crimp Digit, pirate glassblower.
How'd a crusty pirate like yourself wind up making little glass unicorns?
Listen, matey. Glass blowing's every bit as dangerous as sailing the Spanish Main. One false move with your glass jack near the glory hole, you can kiss your eyebrows goodbye.
I can? I'm not sure that's biologically possible. So, unicorns, huh?
Aye. Graceful, delicate creatures they are. Though, to be honest, they aren't selling so well to the pirate community at large. For my next project, maybe I'll be making something that really speaks to them. So many I can ever sell these blasted horny buggers.
Ooh, yeah, the horny buggers. Right. So, what's this alphabet sale all about?
What's this alphabet sale all about?
It's the latest thing. I make unbreakable tubes in the shapes of letters, which can be used to create festive illuminated business signs, novelty mementos, or lamps.
Kitschy.
Aye, very camp. Consonants cost 48 pieces of 8. But today I'm giving away one free vowel per customer. Would you like a vowel?
I'd love a vowel. Yeah.
I think I'd like one of those free vowel tubes.
You'd like to buy a vowel, eh? Here you go.
Look at his face.
What about A, E, I, O, or even Y?
All sold out. All we got is YouTubes these days.
YouTubes. Oh, yeah. Right, so let's get out of here.
Thanks for chatting, but I got a wife and arch-nemesis to return to.
Aye, who doesn't?
Right, so... I don't know what that YouTube's for, but, and YouTube, that's kind of bizarre. But yeah, I'm sure we'll find a way. You basically collect all this stuff, and ultimately, somehow, he ends up completing his goals. So... We'll get on with it, see what else we can find. Okay, and this is what we come across. Portly pirate. Let's talk to him.
Hi. Ah, who are you? I'm Guybrush Threepwood, mighty pirate. And you are?
Joaquin Jacinto de Mera Alfonso de Oro, treasure hunter extraordinaire.
Bit of a mouthful there. What's that big pink piles of dolls all about?
What's that big pink pile of dolls?
Action figurines.
Okay, what's that big pink pile of action figurines over there all about?
Those are my extra pink pajama pieres, the lamest and least valuable of the porcelain power pirates. I loathe Pink Pierre with the white-hot intensity of a million exploding cannonballs.
Your name is D'Oro.
Can I call you D'Oro the Explorer?
No.
What kind of treasure do you hunt? Gold doubloons? Silver triploons?
Anyone can find gold or silver. I look for the rarest of pirate treasures.
I'm almost certain I'm going to regret asking this, but what is the rarest of all pirate treasures?
Porcelain power pirates.
What in the name of Davy Jones's closet organizer are porcelain power pirates?
They're the rarest and coolest action figures ever. I've been tracking them with the Porcelain Power Pirate treasure maps hidden in special boxes of Porcelain Power Pirate pear-flavored breakfast cereal. I've spent years tracking them down, and I've almost got the full set.
How many PP Pirates do you have left?
PP Pirates.
The only Power Pirate I have not found is the ultra-rare, impossible to find dark ninja Dave with killer karate katana. I thought I might find it here on Flotsam Island, but I got scammed.
Scammed?
Jace, some guy in a plaid jacket with waving arms sold me a Ninja Dave map, but he just keeps sending me in circles.
Here we go.
Mind if I take a look at that map?
Take it. It's useless.
I'll let you know if I find anything. You're sure this Dark Ninja Dave is a valuable treasure, right?
It's the stuff that dreams are made of. Porcelain dreams.
Porcelain dreams.
Well, I've got pirate news to make and you've got dolls to play with, so I'll just be on my way.
They're not dolls.
No, Guybrush.
Take that!
They're porcelain pirates. Okay, so... take one of these.
Can I have one of your pink pajama Pierres?
No.
But I thought you didn't like them.
That doesn't mean I don't want them.
Okay. Well, I got that club. Is it Club 31 or Club 41? I got a ticket to go in there, so let's shoot in there and see what we can find. Oh, this is different. So let's go to dock. Well, blow me down, Glassworks. Right. So, I feel like we're on the right track here. We're making progress, as always.
Hey.
So, it's a Club 41, that's the one, so...
Oh, yes, my membership card. Here you go.
Very good, Captain Van Winslow. Here's your blindfold.
Blindfold?
Come now, sir. You know the rules. All probationary Club 41 members must wear blindfolds inside the club.
Right. How silly of me.
As you do.
Very good, sir. Find the step.
I've heard you make a mean grogatini.
Look out!
I'm so sorry. Sorry. Ow!
Get him!
Ow!
Oof! Out for his hand!
You took the hand off me, you cracker croaker!
What a fight! That was spectacular, Driftwood! Best pirate brouhaha I've seen in months!
I don't know what got into me. It was like my hand was possessed or something.
Possessed, you say? Sounds like there may be a follow-up story there. Keep feeding me these boffo pirate stories, Threepwood. I'll be handing over the secrets of Deep Cut before you know it.
Okay, so that worked. But I'm pretty sure we dropped something down here.
What the... You put one of those miniature swords with an olive in my grogatini. I hate those things.
His grogatini. Right, so... we've got him one new story, so I assume he needs multiple... just to... get that location of Deep Cut. I'm gonna go back in the forest, because I just feel we've got more to do in here. We've got a treasure map, so what it leads to, that Dark Ninja Dave. Alright.
Hello again.
Hi. Stop doing that.
Look, it's a Ninja Dave figure with throwing star action.
Quit.
Okay, Guybrush. It's only a little porcelain. Just close your eyes and go to your happy place.
I forgot that.
I didn't see anything.
Sorry, must have been a leaf.
He's got this aversion to porcelain. So, let's go have a hunt round, shall we?
That oyster shell looks so empty without a pearl. Curious.
Ooh. Pile of bombs.
Smilin' Stan's Young Miss Mini Bombs. All the punch of larger mini bombs packed into a smaller package for petite pirate hands. You know, I better just take all of them.
Yeah, why not? Don't leave any for anyone else. Selfish Guybrush, come on. Right, what's this? Calendar.
According to this, it's Sunday, the 12th of Manatee.
Ah, the 12th of Manatee, my birthday. Oh, right, I'm back where we started. So... What? Well, that makes no sense.
I wish I were the mightiest pirate ever.
Oh dear.
Arr, no!
Yikes.
Right, so what we've got so far, we've got an action figure, bomb, a flyer, flower pot, YouTube, Doro the Explorer's map, and Grogatini sword. Ah, so I see where we're going with this. So the sword. So, hold on.
Hey, what do you know? That little teeny sword fits right into Pierre's little teeny hand. He still doesn't look very fearsome.
So I assume we're going to make a Ninja Dave. So... what we've got to do is find some more stuff just to make him look like a ninja. In the meantime, let's have a look at this map.
That jungle sure is noisy.
Okay, so we're at the well. And obviously got a treasure map in his hand, so I'm going to try using that on a well in a second. And it's a pig, monkey. So, I've been hearing monkey, obviously you can hear one now, so I assume that we're following the animal noises according to where we're going. And that should lead us, it says it leads us to Dark Ninja Dave, so I don't know why we're making one, but, well, we might not be, I don't know. Okay, well let's use this map then on here. Ooh. That's weird. Okay, and what was the first animal? I think it was a pig. So, pig, monkey, bee. Okay. So, pig.
So far, so good.
Pig, monkey, so it'll be this way.
Oh, monkey.
Oh, right, so that was wrong.
This looks promising.
Okay, so we heard multiple noises down this path, so I assume that was a pig. Monkey. That's right. This is where my memory is failing me.
That jungle sure is noisy.
So we've done pig, we've done monkey, we've done bee. have we, Dumby? What's up here? No, so this will be B. Right, that's right. So after B, we've got... After B, we have... another monkey? Is that right? Well, we'll soon find out. That's a pig. That's a bee. Monkey.
Ah. So far, so good.
We're on the right track, guys. I think I've got it now. Sorry, I should be writing this down, really. It's probably really annoying for you.
That jungle sure is noisy.
So another pig, then a bee, then a bird. So pig, bee, bird. That's a bird. Pig.
This looks promising.
Bees. And a bird. Okay, bird. Aha! Oh.
Oh, dang. Looks like someone already dug up this treasure.
Oh, so we're going to be planting our version of a Ninja Darwin here for that guy to find. Right, so... so we've got like a speed way of getting there anyway now, so I don't have to do that annoying map thing again. I'm awful at that. Like I said, my memory fails me, so... clearly I'm getting too old for this.
Shortcut.
Right. So, I was thinking earlier about this ink bat. And if we use him on the ink...
Arr, Pink Pajama Pierre, you foiled me plans for the last time. Prepare to meet your maker in the ebon depths of the inky sea.
Sacre bleu! Is this the end of Pink Pajama Pierre?
I guess it's true. Black really is slimming.
Ah, Pierre. It is the end of Pierre. Now we got Ninja Dave. Right, I'm bringing Ninja Dave to the X marks the spot. And we're going to be on a roll. There we go. So let's plant him in here.
Dark Ninja Dave with Killer Katana Cutlass waits stealthily for famed out-of-shape pirate hunter Joaquin D'Oro to find him.
Okay, so if we head back and we give him the map, I assume he'll then find it. Why we're doing all this, I'm not quite sure. I don't know what's in it for me. Alright, let's go back and see him. And then I'm going to cut... once we've spoken to him, I'm going to cut there.
Any news?
And we'll start again next time. But I want to get all your, like I said, all your feedback. What you think of the series. If you've played it before, would love your comments. Let me know what your favourite part has been. Not of this, just of, you know, in the general Monkey Island scheme of things. And yeah, what you think of the game. Would love to hear your thoughts. Go to jungle entrance, but I'll be picking up this regardless. I love the game, so you know I make these videos around you guys, but I've got to love what I'm doing too, and Yeah. So far, loving this game.
En garde!
Okay, so let's give him the map back, see what he says.
Great news, Doro. I think your map isn't a ripoff after all.
It isn't? But I never found anything with it.
You must have been reading it wrong. Here, follow me.
And X marks the spot.
See? I told you I could find it.
Whew. I better start digging.
Oh yeah, just pull a shovel out of your coat.
I hope it's not as deep as the other ones.
Put it back away.
Madre de Dios! Dark Ninja Dave! With Killer Karate Katana! Dark Ninja Dave!
Dark Ninja Dave!
Finally! The full set of porcelain power pirates is mine! All mine! Ow! I got dirt in my eye.
Well, what do I get?
My ears deceive me, or did that poorly pirate just dig up a buried treasure?
He sure did, with a little help from Guybrush Threepwood, Mighty Pirate.
Well, that's fantastic! We haven't had a good buried treasure story in weeks! I'd better catch up with that wheezy pirate before he has a coronary, or worse, starts talking to those boobs from the Times. Snappy pirating, Threepwood. Keep this up, and the secrets of Deep Gut will be all yours.
Nice. So that's what we're doing. We're working on it. I don't know what else. I need to get a ship still. And I've got just the plan. Got me some bombs. See if we can chuck a bomb at him and knock him off instead. Right. So anyway, guys, I'm going to cut it there for now. So, really hope you've enjoyed it. I've loved playing it. I know I don't speak much in it, but I really want you to get a feel for what the game is. Also, there's a lot of dialogue, so, you know, can't talk all the way through that. But anyway, guys, I've been Subliminal vs. Games. You've been watching Tales of Monkey Island. Until next time, take care. Bye, guys.